The University of Michigan's first ever football game was in 1879, a rousing 1-0 victory versus Racine. By the 1920s, the Wolverines were a powerhouse led by Fielding Yost. 1979 was the centennial season, and now it was Bo Schembechler's 10th season and radio announcer Bob Ufer's 34th.
You know what I mean. You can feel the excitement, the tension, the charisma that surrounds that stadium every Saturday afternoon.
Indiana came to Ann Arbor on October 27th, 1979, with head coach Lee Corso bringing back the winning ways to the Hoosiers. But not so fast, my friends. They had never beaten a Bo Schembechler coached team. Michigan was coming off three straight 10-2 seasons, but three consecutive Rose Bowl losses. Expectations were high with a 7-1 record going into the Indiana game, led by a trio of great offensive weapons, wide receiver Anthony Carter, quarterback John Wangler, and running back Butch Wolford. Michigan had a 21-7 fourth quarter lead, but Indiana's shocking touchdown with 59 seconds left made it 21-20, but then...
And you know Lee Corso, what will he do? Will he go for the tie or will he go for the kick? Satisfied with a tie, I guess. That's a moral victory. Kellogg will attempt. He's 2 out of 2. The ball snapped, is spotted, is kicked, is sent over end. It's a brand new ball game, 21-21. 52 seconds remaining.
Corso, kissing his sister, opened the door for one of the top 10 plays in Michigan history and one of the top 10 calls by the legendary Bob Ufer.
Under center is Wangler at the 45. He goes back. He's looking for a receiver. He throws downfield to the corner.
So today is another spectacular Victor's Rewind 2. Live locker room insider chatter with Jamie Morris, John Wangler, Anthony Carter, Ron Simpkins, Mike Jolly, and a surprise Zoom guest coming at you right now.
This is a presentation of the Pro Football Hall of Fame.